Today's video is made possible by the fittings by Akuramaister. Use the link in the description to visit their website. Hello and welcome to today's video that is already the third of the repair of this cello. And in today's video I'm going to work on the soundpost crack that is here on the back. In the previous video, and if you haven't seen it, have a look here, I already opened a part of the back here. So now I have to remove the rest so I can start working. And I will use my usual butter knife to do that. As soon as the back was removed, I went ahead and glued the crack. Now that the crack is glued, I can go ahead. To work on the inner side, I have to be able to put pretty much force on the blade without breaking it, and it has to be steady in place. That's why I'm going to make a shaping mold using plaster that fits precisely to this back. To do that, I will make a case at about the middle of the blade with a soundpost patch at its center. I'm using some MDF and clamps to make it, and I will pour the plaster into it. Making your own violin, viola or cello takes a lot of time and effort, as you know. And that's why, as soon as the instrument is almost ready, I like to treat myself and the instrument, of course, with a nice set of fittings. For this instrument that I made in the Making a Violin series, I used the fittings made by Akuramaister, and I went for a heel model pegs and tailpiece made in ebony, but they have many more. Their product range includes fittings for violin, viola and cello. Mainly they have two series, the Ultimo and Preciso. They use boxwood, ebony, rosewood, snakewood and tin tool, and made the fittings in various models. As you have seen in another video, I have also used the tin tool fittings, and these also look beautiful. For more information and to place an order, visit their website, the link is in the description. Using a template, I mark the shape and position of the soundpost patch. And using my gouges, planes and scrapers, I will make a small pit until 2/3 of the thickness of the blade. Now that the hole in the back is ready, I can start working on the patch, and I have already cut a piece of maple on the right shape. I will start working on it with the planes, and then I will go ahead with the files. Thank you. As you see, I have put a bit of red chalk on the back that is going to leave a mark on the patch. In this way, I know where I have to remove some wood. This is a slow process that has to be done again and again many times. It took me almost a whole afternoon to make it. Finally, I can glue the patch on place. The last thing that I have to do now is shape the patch to fit the inner side of the bag at the same curve and thickness. I will do that with gouges, planes and scrapers. Finally, as I don't want the patch to remain so clear, I will put a little bit of stain on it. And so the SandPost patch is ready. Now the last thing that I want to do before I glue the back on the ribs is glue the joint that is open and put a small reinforcement piece. And now it's time to glue the back on the ribs. And so the cello has to dry again. That means that we arrived at the end of today's video. In the next video, I'm going to work on the rest of the small things, make the bridge and finish. I have to see what I'm going to do with the fingerboard, clean the instrument and mount it, of course. Let me thank once again Akura Meister for supporting today's video. As you have seen, I have also used their pegs on the cello. And in the next video, I'm also going to use their end pin and tailpiece. Many thanks also to the Patreons for supporting the channel. If you also appreciate the content and would like to support my channel, don't hesitate to visit my Patreon page. Otherwise, you can also subscribe and like the video, and I will see you next time again. Bye bye!